I made a copy of ODB 14 and renamed this to ODB 17, Intro to Queries. We're going to take a little break from forms. We will return to them after we add a few more tables to our database. Before that, we're going to take a look at queries. So let's click on Query in the database window. This gives us three task options. We can create a query in Design View, use Wizard to create query, or create query in SQL View, which some people might pronounce as SQL View. Before I go any further, I'd like to take a quick moment to talk about SQL SQL pronunciation. In the early 1970s, the people at IBM created a way to retrieve data from a relational database system. That's what we have here. Although we only have one table at the moment, we will add more. They named their new creation SQL for Structured English Query Language, but someone else already had SQL trademarked. So they took out the word English and made it SQL for Structured Query Language. Some people call it SQL, some people call it SQL. I'll use the terms interchangeably throughout this tutorial series. So why is SQL so important? Because it's the industry standard programming language for relational databases. All the filters and queries that we've already used in LibreOffice Base actually create an SQL query and run that query to create our filtered output. We'll see how this happens when we create a query in Design View. So let's do that now. Go to Design View and click. What LibreOffice Design View is might also be referred to as QBE or Query by Example. That's the screen we're looking at right here. It's meant to be an easier way of creating SQL. We see the Add Table or Query dialog box. If I accidentally close the dialog box before adding a table, I'll want to go up into Insert and Add Table or Query, or I can hit F7. Let's add the only table available. And if I add it a second time, it's not a problem. We can remove it by right-clicking on the top and delete. To get more space, I'm going to put my arrow over the scroll bar and bring it down. And I can't quite see all the fields on my database, but if I put my arrow over the bottom, we get the double-sided arrow and can open that up a little more. It also works from the side. To add a field to our query, I can click and drag it down, or I can double-click on it. To remove a field from our query, I would right-click and delete. We see the employee ID has got a little key next to it, showing us that it's the key field for this table. We haven't said a whole lot about key fields yet. We've just mentioned that each employee must have their own unique employee number. Above that, we've got an asterisk. If I double click this asterisk, or click and drag it to put it into our selection criteria, I'm going to remove the name. If we run our query, and we can run it by either clicking on the Run Query, hitting F5, or Edit, Run Query. And here we also see our icon and our F5. This shows us our result set, that is, all the fields and the data on the table that we asked for in our query. The result set is the name of the information returned from a query. To hide the result set, we can go into View and click this Preview or hit F4 to turn it off. And F4 will also bring it right back. I'm hitting F4 to hide my result set. And I want to create another query, so I'm going to remove this. I'm going to add the last name and the first name, and I'm double-clicking to get them in my selection criteria. I'm going to run this by hitting F5. And our result set has all the names on the database. We see we're at row number 1 of 28, And everything we've done so far is in LibreOffice Design View, also known as QBE or Query by Example. Earlier, I mentioned the importance of SQL code to a relational database management system, and how everything we've done so far creates SQL code and runs that code to give us our result set. To view that code, we can go under View, switch to Design View on off. And there's our code. It's not lined up very well, so it's a little difficult to read. I'm going to format this a little differently to make it easier to read. With this formatted, it's a little easier to read. We can see select last name and first name from table employees. I'm going to update my SQL code. I want to select last name, first name, and department. So I'm going to add department. You might notice that I put the comma on the left of the next field instead of the right of the field before it. The computer doesn't care what side you put the comma on. It's a personal preference. Over the years, I found there's a lot less you missed a comma or you have an extra comma errors if I place the comma on the left. Let's run this query by hitting F5, and we see it works. Now let's see what our SQL code looks like if we go back to Design View. And it looks just like we would expect it to. Let's go back to the SQL code again. And we see our formatting is lost. LibreOffice won't keep our SQL code formatted for us. So if we want to keep it formatted, we need to make a copy of our SQL code and hold it maybe in a text file. Maybe someday someone will create a LibreOffice extension that will format our SQL code. Now that we have our query complete, let's save it. I'm going to click on the Save. And because it's the first time, it's asking us for the name. Do we want to call this Query 1? No, I'm going to call this Query Employee Name and Department. I'm going to save this. And now we can close our window. And here it is under Queries. If I double click, it will run. If I right click, we can edit it, and it brings us into design mode, or right click and edit in SQL view. And I'll save our database.